All right, welcome to part two, and let's talk a little bit of movie news. As you guys know, pretty much every single theater is closed, and the pandemic situation isn't getting any better. Heck, it's actually gotten worse so far. And with that, one of the bigger summer blockbusters that was coming out this year, Wonder Woman 1984, which was supposed to drop on June 5th, was really looking forward to it, has been moved a whole 2 months to August 14th, because Warner Brothers and the producers who made the movie, they were kind of talking and they were thinking maybe we can launch the movie on HBO Max to, you know, drive up the subscriptions there, because apparently this is according to Grace Randolph, by the way. She's pretty reputable, to be honest. And she was talking about how the Snyder Cut was going to be like a special thing. They were going to lure the subscribers in to get the HBO Max. But currently, Snyder Cut isn't on the table because Zack Snyder wanted to shoot additional scenes. Because obviously, it's been like 3 years since he's shot his original cut of the movie, and apparently he wants to add a few more scenes to make it even more epic. And apparently the ideas he has are like crazy, and he, in order to add those scenes, he needs to film some other stuff. So because of the, you know, the pandemic that's going on right now, he can't shoot those scenes right now. So Snyder Cut, apparently it's coming, but it's currently delayed because of what's going on right now. So Warner's thought, okay, and the Friends special isn't happening either, because, you know, the Rona happened, and obviously you can't have gatherings and stuff. So, and that special was going to be like all the original cast members coming back and just sitting in a round table or something like that. So that's not happening. So they thought, okay, let's.
That's no fun. I want an actual reunion, a TV show, Friends, man.
I know, right? Me too. An actual.
I don't want them sitting at a round table. I want to see Chandler and Joey being Chandler and Joey. Come on.
Yeah, I know, but that was their special attraction. But that's not happening. So they thought, okay, if Snyder Cut's not happening right now, if Friends reunion's not happening right now, let's release Wonder Woman 1984 to, like, you know, get as many subscribers as possible. But the producers were like, this movie, that's crazy, because this movie can potentially make $1 billion. There is no way we're just going to push it on a subscription service, and that it's going to make no money other than the money it brings in from the subscribers. And that's not guaranteed money, because we don't know how many subscribers HBO Max is going to get on day one, and, you know, the first week and stuff like that. So I guess they came to a compromise, and they were like, okay, June 5th kind of looking iffy, so I guess we'll just move it to August 14th. And, you know, it's like, okay, I'm not sure, was that a panic move, or like, should they have stayed at June 5th? Because I mean, I'm no fortune teller, but I feel like by June 5th, I think most people would have felt comfortable enough to go to a movie, and that's a prime spot for Wonder Woman 1984. Wonder Woman 1984 could have been the first movie a lot of people saw after quarantine. I think it still might be, you know, they just moved it 2 months. Just saying that makes me disappointed. Like, two more months, because the movie was already delayed from November. It was supposed to come out last November. Now it's moved to June, and then now it's moved to August. So it's like really frustrating as a movie.
Why did it get delayed the first time?
Ziegler, apparently they had to do reshoots for the movie. That's why it was moved to June.
Well, a lot of us just don't know when this pandemic is going to end. So
yeah,
that's like why everything is just being moved to the end of the year.
Yeah. Obviously, you know, like Black Widow also moved. That was supposed to come on May 1st, and nobody knows what May is going to look like. I mean, June, you can't tell what that looks like, but it's like, it should be better than what's going on right now. So I want to get your guys' thoughts on, you know, the Snyder Cut delay and the Wonder Woman 1984 delay. Ziggler, your thoughts?
The Snyder Cut, I mean, we've been talking about this shit for years, and it looks like it's finally happening. But Snyder's supposed to reshoot some scenes, or add new scenes or whatever.
Yeah, he's gonna add new scenes because he's got new ideas since he's shot.
Are they gonna involve Batman? Because I don't think Ben Affleck's gonna return as Batman. Obviously I got Gal Gadot, Jason Momoa. I'm not sure about Henry Cavill though. I'm not sure if he's gonna return as Superman. So
he was talking to somebody on Vero, his social media account. He was like, the reshoots might involve somebody. Yeah. That's first name Green, so he was hinting at maybe a Green
lantern,
but apparently Green Lantern is already in his cut, or he can add some more Green Lantern stuff, or by
imagine
Green
if they add Stephen Amell.
True, or by Green he meant the Martian Manhunter, because you know he's Green too. He said he wanted to shoot scenes with Henry Lennox, the actor who was supposed to play Martian Manhunter.
Like Green Arrow.
Yeah, or Green Arrow. Who knows?
Yeah, I guess Stephen Amell in there. Yeah, it won't happen, but it's fun to fantasize. When is HBO Now? Or what is it called, HBO Now? Yeah, when is that
called? HBO Max?
Max.
HBO Max is coming out May 2020, so I guess sometime in May, like May 15, I think.
All right, well, they have time to do all this stuff, but it's definitely a good thing that did not release Wonder Woman 1984 on fucking streaming, because Wonder Woman 1984 is a goddamn blockbuster, okay? That's going to make a billion easy. Everyone liked the first one. They're going to come see the second one. I want to see it. I want to see it really bad. I'm kind of pissed it's moved to August. It's moved to August, right? Yeah, August. I don't know. I just hate that this coronavirus thing is fucking everything up, but it's gonna get worse before it's gonna get better. So I don't know how long it's going to go on. It could go on till August. Hopefully not. Jesus Christ. I hope it comes to an end during April. It's obviously not going to be the beginning of April, because that's what, next week? I don't know. This shit's just crazy. I hope. Jesus.
Yeah, me too. I hope all this is kind of done as soon as possible, but I think
Think it's going to be done now. That's the thing.
Yeah.
But that's like we're hoping it's by April, though.
Yeah. Like, I think the worry for a lot of Hollywood people is that even if everything gets back to normal, like sometime in April, people might not feel safe enough to go to the theater. So it's like, to maximize as many customers as possible, they kind of move it.
I mean, in China, they were about to reopen all the theaters, but then they shut it all down again because, the coronavirus is still out there.
And people aren't feeling safe enough to go out. And they were playing, like, old movies like Inception and The Avengers, Endgame, and stuff like that.
Yeah. I don't think they're going to, I don't know. I don't think people are going to feel safe in April yet. I think you have to wait another month or two.
Right.
People are going to want to go outside, but because they hate being quarantined, I'm not sure they're going to feel safe.
Yeah. I mean, that's probably the first place I'll go after the quarantine. It's the movie theater, to be honest.
Oh, but, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. And Cam, your thoughts?
It's another case of we don't know when the virus is going to end, so we're just going to move everything to the last 4 or 5 months of the year. A lot of stuff's being moved to the end of the year or even farther. It's better As for Wonder Woman actually being, it's better to have to wait and release it versus put it on streaming, because that's is a huge movie. It's a blockbuster. It's going to make bank. But as for the Snyder Cut, what we've all been talking about for the past year or so, even though I haven't really been glancing at it much, it took a whole virus for it to actually start to see it get a release date. Like, or not yet, at least. I'm hoping it gets a release, since people have been clamoring for it for the past few, for months to years now.
Yeah, that's true. True. But yeah, we'll see when it comes out. And yeah, Hollywood's having a tough time, you know. $0 at the box office this past weekend for the Cinemark first time in history.
To lay off hundreds of employees and hundreds of theaters. Sean is one of them.
Right. It's sad to see, man. Like, yeah, hopefully the industry, I mean, hopefully the movie theaters recover, you know, but
movies like Birds of Prey and Rise of Skywalker have to come out early on digital and physical just right. Because of the pandemic.
Right. Like, yeah, I just hope this doesn't just end Hollywood. Birds of Prey was out like
last month. Everything came out. Dude, I saw The Way Back that was on there. The Way Back's on digital now. The Hunt. Yeah. I just saw The Hunt. And Invisible Man 2 is out.
Yeah, that's funny. I saw The Way Back literally like 4 days before everything got serious.
Oh yeah, also Bloodshot is on that. Dude, I saw Bloodshot the day everything got serious.
Yeah, I think I remember that, yeah.
Oh yes, yeah. That fateful Wednesday where everything fell apart.
Yeah, so let's keep our eyes open and we'll see what happens.
Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed that video and make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And click on the channel to check out some more awesome videos like our movie and wrestling debates and our interviews with people like the Wrestling Classic and Jordan Jomo from the IGWC. And we are definitely looking into delivering you all some more content in the near future, so definitely be on the lookout for that. And thank you for your support.